What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Malik, back on your screen with another tip for the tube. A really cool way to increase your views is by adding captions to your videos, just like the ones you can see below by clicking on the CC button under this video. When viewers see the CC under your video, they know that means that you've added captions to your video for the hearing impaired. A lot of people add a filter for captions to their searches, so if you got captions in your videos, this will bump your videos up when people add that filter to their search. When your videos have captions, people from other countries who speak other languages can actually go to the captions options and translate the language to the language that they speak, and they can follow along with your videos as well, which also bumps up your views. The text from the captions acts as additional metadata, so that along with the keywords that you have makes your video more Google-licious and makes it more relevant. So if your captions are about a specific topic, then this will make your video more relevant for the search, thus for bumping it up in Google's lovely search engine. Now that we talked about all the advantages that captions bring to the game to help you get your views up, I'll go ahead and show you how to add captions to your videos. Let's jump off into YouTube. There's two quick and easy ways to get to the captions. If you're on the video manager page, go to the video that you want to add captions and click on edit. Then click on subtitles and closed captions. Another quick and easy way to get to the closed caption screen.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Malik back.
Shut up, you. Another quick and easy way to get to the captions is by going to the video page where the video plays at and clicking on the captions button underneath the video. First thing you want to do is make sure that the video language is correct. If it's not correct, click on change language. Go to the drop down arrow here. And then you can type in the language that you want and you'll have all the selections you can choose from. Since my video language is English, I'm going to leave it as it is. Now, click on add subtitles or captions. You click on that, you select your language, and you're presented with three choices. Two of these are pretty much the same, but a little different. I'm going to start from the bottom up. I'm going to start off with create new subtitles or captions. When you click on this one, what it allows you to do is it allows you to play the video and you type in the words as it's speaking. Now, the reason why I like this one is if I haven't created a file already to put in with my captions, I get to see the waveform down here and I can basically tell where I need to stop and start a new sentence. For example, if I hit play, unmute this.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Malik back on your screen with another.
So I like what I put here. What's good, YouTube? And if I hit plus, it'll let me go ahead and start adding other stuff. Hit another plus, it'll let me add another sentence under here. So you can see that it added everything here, but it might not be right. Matter of fact, I'm talking here, but my words are way back here. So I can just left click, hold my left mouse down, and drag this to where I want it to go. Now I can tell with the waveform that that's probably too far too. So I'm going to drag this in right here to right where the speaking stops in the waveform. I'm going to drag this one over. And this one might be too far too, so I'm going to drag that one in, drag this one over, and now let's see how I did.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Malik back on your screen.
Okay, so I got some of that wrong. So I can just cut that out. All right, so let's see how I did now.
It's your boy Malik back on your screen with another tip for the two.
Now that went too far. So instead of doing anything, all I got to do is put my cursor here and drag this over to where I stopped speaking. So as you can see, just from these three little lines, I got captions now. You could do this for your whole video.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Malik back on your screen with another tip for the two.
So I like this option. It's pretty cool. It's a good way to do it. So I'm going to go back. And I'm going to click on this one here that I made. And I'm going to delete it. All right. So if I click on Add Subtitles or Captions again, select English. And I'll select the second version, which is Transcribe and Set Timings. So if I click on this one, then what happens is I just type everything that it's saying and YouTube will try to match up the words with the timings in the video. Instead of giving me the waveform at the bottom that I had before that I can make my own adjustments, YouTube actually tries to line it all up for me. Now, my experience is that when I've used this version, I've had to move it around anyway. So I kind of like the other version better because if I'm going to move stuff around, I might as well do it myself and make sure it's how I like it to be. But this is an option you can use as well. So let's go ahead and delete this subtitle or again. And I could have left it on there. It really doesn't matter, but just trying to keep it clean. So now I'm going to go to English again. And I'm going to go to upload a file. Now, YouTube will allow you to upload certain files that you've already typed up for your transcripts. Now, if you use a regular .txt file, a text file, and you go ahead and upload that, then YouTube will set the timings for you. You'll probably have to make some adjustments. But then if you have a subtitle file like a .smi or a .srt file, those can also be brought into YouTube. And when you bring those in, they have their own timings with those files. So .smi and .srt files have timings that speak to YouTube and say, this is where the text goes. Don't worry about it, YouTube. You don't got to figure it out. So if you have the ability to have captions that have a tool that creates captions with a .srt or a .smi file, YouTube will take those. So let's say I wanted to pick a file here. Let's say I got this SRT file here and I'll open that up. So YouTube says, hey, I know what that is. So I click on upload and it went ahead and uploaded it. And it gives me the chance to make any adjustments to it as well. If I need to do so, I can drag stuff around, move where I need it to be, all that good stuff, just in case it wasn't right. But as you can see, the timings are set. It was real quick because it already had the timing set with it. Usually, if you do a text file, so let's go back and let's do a text file. Let me get rid of this. If I do a text file, you'll see that it's going to take a long time because YouTube is trying to figure it out. If I leave it on transcript and I do choose file, I'll do this text file here and click on upload. And now it's in here. Pretty much got the text all in here where I want. Now I'll do set timings. And it's going to take a while for it to set the timing because YouTube is trying to match up my words with the words in the video and set up all the timings. But once it's done, all you got to do is make the adjustments if you need to make any from the timings that YouTube made, and you're straight. Captions. Easy as pie, wasn't it?
All right, guys.
You know the routine. The thumb. The one that's pointed in the upward direction. Click it, like it, live it, love it, hug it. Show the thumb some love. Comments. You know I love comments. Leave me questions, I'll give you answers. Alright? You need help? You're in the right place. Don't forget, subscribe. Click on the little button to the side. Get your sub on. Get your sub on. And if you need some more YouTube love, all you gotta do is watch these videos. Watch these videos. You guys know what to do, so get to clicking.